It's all go at Greenleaf Pastures. And with 280 cows, mating comes with a typical set of challenges. But this year, something new is on the horizon. Jared from CowManager is on the ground getting insights into Brian and Rachel's first mating season with CowManager.
Hey team, just pulling into Greenleaf here. Going to catch up with Brian, leading into his first week of mating, so I'm going to gauge on how he's feeling and what the plan is.
So it's your first season, mating starting. What challenges have you got coming on board?
Accuracy and heat detection is always a big one for us, and just putting the time in to get that. Normally we just look across the feed pad and draft off there, and we've always done tail pain and scratches beforehand. This year we're relying probably 80% on CowManager, if not 90%, and it just all appears on your phone. But the challenges moving forwards will be we're not going to run any bulls this year, so we want to eliminate bulls from our system, and then where bulls used to run is put short gestation semen in.
How have you found using the system, learning the system? You know, is that harder than what you would have thought?
Yeah, I'm really comfortable with the system actually. With what we've seen out in the paddock, the pre-mating heats and the grabs are really easy to understand on individual cows. You can see if they're like, it's got colour coded of blue, light green and green, which really shows that they're on heat. That's all extremely easy to understand. I'm really looking forward to it because the system's done all our pre-mating heats and stuff, so it'll be quite interesting to get to the other end of the stick where our pregnancy results come all the way back to what was happening now, then also when the cow transitioned, and see if there's any patterns or anything that's happened to what our cows in the first 3 weeks are calving compared to our empty cows is, and if there's anything in there we could fix for the following season. And one of the things will be interesting to see will be how well it picks up the cows. The only thing that gets us, or if anything seems to fail and we don't pick up on time, just since our first season with the system, and we've got to keep on top of the tags and everything too, which the system is really good at alerting us, which we've found. So we have tail painted the cows as much as that disgusts you, Jared. Yeah, so we've tail painted them just to help us also gauge our eye in on what the system's telling us at the very crucial time of mating, because we've all be seeing each individual cow as we put them up. And then also it would give us, we like to record as much information as possible around what the cows are showing us, how much they're rubbed, if they're early, if they're not. That's what we normally used to do with tail paint. Now we have the system that's literally following the cow everywhere it goes, telling us exactly what it thinks and apparently when she's in the perfect window for insemination. So we're also going to record all that data too, and then we can compare the two and just see, just analyse what the system's telling us of what we've missed as humans in the past before too. And then from there on it'll just give us a more of an accurate benchmark and what the system's doing for us and what value it's adding to our business. And then moving forwards, the aim will be just to solely rely on CowManager and hopefully eliminate a lot of labour that gets put around during the mating time, especially when we expand our business and go bigger.
And so begins mating at Greenleaf Pastures. But that's not the end of Brian and Rachel's story. Come back in a few weeks to see how CowManager has helped improve their mating. Until then, head over to CowManager.com to see how CowManager can improve your herd.